grow with us today.
You know, when you're governor of the state, it is always great to spend a little time in one of your outstanding public schools. Just a real quick before you started, just like you all get grades, we grade schools. Okay? And what we have done over the last few years is make that grading harder. We have what's called MCIP-5 now, only method. I just want to tell you that we watch every school and every community, and those numbers are out there, and we raise the bar. Over the last 3 or 4 years, we have made those state evaluations much tougher. And I'm here to tell you that this school district scored 96.1 on new tests, folks. That's we do that. none of what we're talking about here in your school would be possible if there wasn't a subset of people that were willing to take public service as their lifetime and be teachers, administrators, and workers in our public schools. It is really easy for folks outside that system to be critical. It is incredibly easy for them to be whining. But I would hope that there are some people here that will take up public education as a career and continue to find level of commitment that your teachers and staff have done here. Education is a value we share in the state, not a political position. And those that come after it or attack it are not what we need to do to move forward. We need to continue to work to support these folks. Last piece. Now, I talk a lot about a number of things. Everything I've talked about basically comes to the conclusion that this community, our state, these teachers, this staff, is trying to do whatever they can to give you the greatest possibility to get as much economic independence, raise family, live a life, make some money, and do what you want. But that's all they can really do. Ultimately, it's up to you. I mean, ultimately, all of this is providing you a better opportunity than your parents had. And trying to provide you a way to move forward. So, there's one lesson I'm going to take from this assembly today. So, if you're hard work, if you work hard every day, the sky's the limit. So, take the blueprint of your education is giving you and use it to start building. This is the last thing I tell every high school kid that I get a chance to see. Be involved in as many possible things as you can over your high school. Okay? If you like to be in a play, be in a play. If you like to play an instrument, play an instrument. If you like to play sport, play sport. If you want to be in a club, get in a club. You're never going to have the opportunity you have this time that you have this time in your life, where you have as much freedom with your schedule as you're ever going to have. Believe me, it's not going to get any easier. And so it's really, really important that you absorb the richness of opportunity. So what we want you to do is use your opportunities in this education to build a solid path to a college degree, if you want to go to college, or a trade, or a skill, if you want to go that way. But more importantly, use that and the community you're involved in here to build strong families, vibrant communities, and a prosperous state. And working together, we're going to build a secure nation and a safe place in the world. Because each and every day, each of us decides what kind of community live in. And the folks are willing to do a little work, they make that community better. Each day